Why am I so dark? What is going on? What's up, guys? You know, this camera is not the best to take photos with. I need a photographer. But it's fine because I still need to film videos. People are dumb as fuck. So, good morning. On today's episode of Why Am I Still Waiting Around? You know, I really don't know. It's a Saturday, so I'm not really tripping out, but like, you know, it'd be nice if I had some more motion going for myself other than what I've already been working on, working towards. This is really, you know, the most important aspect of making money is talking to an audience like this and sharing my thoughts with you guys. On a daily basis, I do have a lot of wisdom that I want to share with the world. And, you know, I don't like my time being wasted, so I'm going to do my best to not waste your guys' time with what I say and how I articulate my words. With that being said, you know, this is going to be the first look into my world of enlightenment and teachings for you guys, and how to, you know, navigate your way through life without excess stress or worry that some people may or may not have put into your life. So, unintentionally, you know. Or maybe it is intentional. Who knows? That's up to you to figure out and to differentiate from. That's for you to differentiate and understand in your own path and journey of who you are and where you want to your life to go, where you want your life to take you as an individual experiencing this consciousness. So, that being said, peace be with you.
What's up?
Why is there so many lines on here? What the fuck is that? Why is it looking like this? But, we're making some broccolini. You know the vibes. And I'm actually kind of vibing with this, but
I ain't gonna worry about it right now. I'm just like standing in my kitchen reflecting on my day. I just woke up to Wednesday. Should have been working today. And I just woke up from like a 6-hour nap. So I'm tired, but okay. And I'm like, why am I tired? And it's because yesterday I was literally driving around all of San Diego and did so much. Tomorrow I have to wake up at like 5 a.m. going to this new fitness class a new fitness gym that just opened down the street. They have like free classes going on, so I'm going to go in and check it out. Starts at like 6:30. And then after that, also I'm cooking some broccolini, and there's lines in my camera. I don't know why. But what else? Then I have to go to the doctor tomorrow after the appointment at like 8 a.m. And then I think I have a campus tour. So that's like 9 a.m. to 10, and then I have to drive back down to San Diego. And I have this campus tour. And of course, nothing's in my calendar. Like, nothing. I just... Oh, here. Yeah, it is. Wait, what the fuck? Oh, that was yesterday. Yeah, I have nothing written down. And then... So, then I have a little tour. Someone's gonna walk me around, like, this campus to get certified in massage therapy. And then I have an MMA class at like 1. Like 1 to 2. So I'm gonna be going non-stop until like 2 p.m. tomorrow. I don't know how the F I'm gonna do it, but I'm trying to like absorb all the energy I can now. I need to eat some protein. Like, with this, like, I have to think about, like, nutrition, like, what I'm gonna eat, you know. I have to prepare myself in that sense so I can actually perform tomorrow. Then after that, then I'm gonna probably take a nap in my car because I'll be tired as fuck. And then I have a class in the evening at 5, so I have like an hour in between my work. I have two workout classes, so my MMA class and then my my fitness class in the morning. So that should be cool. I do need to go to the DMV too, so I don't know how the fuck I'm gonna do this. I was trying to go to the DMV today, but that just did not happen. So also I'm really trying to watch what I eat, and it's different like saying, oh, like watching what you're eating, but actually like doing, like eating better, you know. It's like two different things, eating better and watching what you could be watching what the fuck you make and eat, like physically, like watching, like, or you could actually be making a difference and eating better. So it's all progress, and you know, just can't be, you know, when you do mess up, because we all mess up, you can't be too hard on yourself, that's for sure.
Ever since I got my own place, my shopping habits have been different. I shop locally. I shop at like local produce places. I try to at least. It's a lot cheaper if you shop organically. Makes you really look at the world differently. Hola, buenas tardes, chiqueños. Hoy nosotros tenemos un live. You see. Today I'm looking for a job. I should have been vlogging yesterday, not gonna lie. I'm also live, but so I got some viewers on here already. But this week was my first week at UFC gym, and I'm going to be starting to train because your girl wants to start MMA fighting and boxing. So, also yesterday I did some really fun stuff that I also really wanted to vlog, but my camera was dead. I've been running around trying to find my camera battery for the past week. Couldn't find it, but I finally found it. It's no excuse. But I went all the way to, I drove all the way up north, and I copped these two clothing racks, as you can probably see a little bit of, from Forever 21 that was going out of business. So they were selling all of their items, and I remember I walked in, I was there like sometime last year, and they were saying that they were closing their whole store down. And I was like, yo, like, okay, I actually asked, I was like, can I get some clothing racks from, like, they're like, oh, like, we don't know, it's in the future, like, we don't know anything. But so I went back, I was like scrolling on my phone, I was on Facebook Marketplace, and I saw that they were selling the clothing racks. So I was like, oh my god, didn't I literally inquire about those like last year? So I answered the posting, and I show up, and there's two clothing racks literally perfect for exactly what I need. And I'm like, yes, like, let me get those. So it was a success, and shout out Forever 21, but not really, because you guys did not know at the time. This could have been done quicker, but I think they're pretty cool, and I thought they were worth it to have. So now I have two clothing racks from Forever 21, and they're pretty good, like, material. I don't know. I don't need any more shit in my house, but if I were to do like a pop-up sale, those would be fucking lit to use. So, never say never, you know? They'll be put to good use. And they were free too, so. So yeah. Yeah. Shout out my live stream. And yeah, so now I believe it's raining outside. The weather is very shitty. I had I should be good for like the whole day. I'm cutting weight. I'm trying to cut weight for boxing, but I think I'll lose it naturally. I'm not gonna stress out, really. because I'm at like 129, 128, and freaking, what's her fucking name? Tracy Cortez, the number one contender for MMA fighting right now. Well, I don't know if she's number one. Well, she is number one. She's number one. And she weighed like 126 back like last year. So, you know, our weight fluctuates. It's not something to be stressing out over. It fluctuates naturally with the seasons, but it is something to take into consideration when, you know, you are on a timely thing and, you know, you are going to be training for something like that where it does matter. But yeah, I'm supposed to be getting in touch with a coach today. And then hopefully I find out if I get like one of the three jobs that I applied for as a massage therapist and esthetician to work at a spa and practice health and wellness much more and educate you guys on health and wellness and what I do personally and what I've learned. Because I have learned a lot over the years, and you know, a lot of it is breaking these habits that a lot of people have. Not only me, I used to have very, very bad habits. And it's really just about educating yourself of what you are putting in your body, what that does for you, and how that can, you know, prevent anything or, you know, any preventative measures that you can take to support your health and wellness and well-being is perfect and A1 always. Change your genetic complex to bettering yourself. So, yeah. That's all I got for my vlog today. Vlog. I guess I'll just show you these. Also, I'm not wearing any pants. My bad. On my live, people probably just saw my ass. It's fine. It's only one person. It's chill. But yeah, here are these. Super cool. Super cool. I think they're cool. I have another clothing rack also that I just purchased. I'm like, why did I even buy it in the first place? Because I knew I fucking wanted these, so I just don't like waiting. As you can tell, I don't like waiting on anybody, so that's that. But yeah. I'm going to get ready for the day. I think I'm going to get a Celsius from the store. And then I need to ship off some stuff so you guys can follow me while I do so. And hopefully my camera doesn't die. Oh my god, why is this upside down? Hello. Hello. This, throw it away. This gets moved. And I wish I could see myself in another viewfinder, but it is motherfucking okay. Because shit is hitting the fucking wall. You know. God. Fuck my life, dude.
Literally.
So, I just bought this. I just, like, put it together, and I have this. And I got it, and I put it together, and I'm like, fuck, I don't need half the shit that I bought and put together. And also this motherfucking exposure, though. Like, I don't even know.
This, I really want to move. This is like hella in the way.
You know, working out though.
It's a workout for life. Here, thank God for the space, for the vibes.
Shit hurts.
But hey.
And then
I have all of this.
Perfect is this? I can't get over it.
I'm so smart. And I just really like the space. Like, I don't want to see any extra space, you know? I got one shirt sold. I've been waiting so long to do all of this while resting at the same time. So hope that I get this stuff sold immediately so I can just really, this is cute. I will be wearing these pants tomorrow night or Monday night, Friday. Should get sold, but everything's gotta go. Always room for improvement and new items. sell one thing and you get something better. But always trying to upgrade our lives. It's all about a lot of storage that, honestly, doesn't serve me. But hope, but it was cost like $4.45 to send out a package today. So yeah, man, I'm just. But this is like. I'm like, I got a whole chill down my spine because this is what I've worked. I've put myself through hell just for this moment. To be able to sit here in front of this screen with my clothes on a real rack from Forever 21 that I got for free. And honestly, like, it's worth it. It's really worth it. And I have another rack right here that is also really cool, but it's like official. It makes a difference when it's official, you know? And I've worked so hard, I've sacrificed so much just to be official, you know? Sacrifice so much just so I can sit here and talk to a camera. But at least it's in the comfort of my own home. It's a beautiful house. It's a beautiful home. Could definitely use some remodeling. It's very dry in here. It's very dry. I would love to get a humidifier on and buy a humidifier. But yeah, it's really fucking hot and loud. It's really loud. My freaking microphone isn't even plugged in. I should probably plug it in. Y'all can probably barely hear me. Let me plug it in.
Hold up. 3, 2, 1. Now it's plugged in. Hopefully that makes a difference. I can't wait to play all this footage back online just to hear it.
And see what the fuck I have right now. Like I was saying, you know, this took a fucking long time to set myself up to be like this. But yeah. She's lit, she's tight. I'm very happy. You know, shit happens. Money gets wasted. But everything is a try and fail. You're gonna always fail. That's how you grow, is by failing and learning. So with that being said, I'm going to continue to organize my house, get this vanity sold because I don't need it, even though I spent like 3 hours putting it together, and I purchased it for like $150. I'm only gonna get $100 out of it, which sucks ass, because I literally just bought this too, and like I'm basically just wasting more energy and wasting more money on it. But I guess, you know, it's a lesson. I meant for more, you know. I'm not gonna, it's just lessons on lessons on lessons. But that builds strength. That builds strength. That doesn't build weakness for nothing. And I'm still very young. So yeah. I got a lot of shit I gotta handle at the same time that I am handling. And you gotta build it up somewhere. You gotta make shit happen regardless, by yourself. So I'm really excited, and I've been manifesting this. My manifestations are coming into fruition quickly. So I'm very eager to see them happen. Put a lot of money down the drain, and I'm not necessarily okay with it, but at least it's put me somewhere, you know. So yeah, I got this ring light right here. I'm just gonna plug it in, get some real lighting on me. So let's try to do that right now. I have a laptop that I'll be using with a USB adapter, and we're gonna go ahead and I guess place my laptop on my vanity that's right here. And I have my everything is moving how it should, and that's all that fucking matters, to be honest. So I don't know why this is so loose. But the pressure is on. Like this can go higher, but maybe I'm wrong. I don't really know. Feeling like Joe Rogan right about now. Shout out Joe Rogan. I'd love to be on your podcast, Joe Rogan, if you hear this. We are live. Okay. Let's see if we can get this lighting better. quieter, perhaps. We need real studio lights, because this is not bright enough. Oh. Maybe. So, I do have another light, but it's for aesthetics. So, that's probably good. Oh my god. Oh, this feels so good. You guys, like, don't even understand how badly I wanted to, like, put myself in front of a fucking camera like this for so long. I just needed to focus. And we will be perfect. How's that? Still out of focus. Okay. What am I pressing? Hi. I don't know, but we're still alive. Like, out of the frame. This tripod is not doing it for me. I knew it wouldn't when I bought it, but I still bought it so I can at least do something. You feel me? So, I'm gonna take a photo of this. Because it's at least something.
Good afternoon, True for San Diego. This is Leisha.
Hi, I'm calling. Do you have open gym tomorrow?
No, Friday nights from 5 to 8 p.m.
Only Fridays?
Only Fridays.
Okay, for sure. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye.
Okay, entonces, aquí andamos. En lugares, en la lugar. ¿Cuántos tiempos? Tomás de hacemos aquí hacer aquí
red bills, niggas up at all. I pulled up this skirt off. Box shots, he smeared off. 40 ounce of that crystal. Rose, that Rick Rose. Got it jumping like Chris Cross. Mitch matching, no jigsaw. No horseplay when we quit draw. Pussy nigga, get a tip job. Hands up, stick your mans up. Your time's up, the new brand's up. Black, you.
I'm Dion.
All about you.
Seven spice or Korean five spice, but I think that's what it is, but I don't. All I have is sriracha, and I have red hot crushed pepper flakes. So, dear God, thank you for this meal and keeping me alive tonight and healing my body and keeping me out of trouble and keeping me sober. Thank you, God, for healing me and keeping me safe and keeping everybody around me safe and keeping me focused and keeping me busy and with shit to do and allowing me to be able to interview for jobs and continue with what I started and keeping me healthy and keeping me sane, keeping me out of trouble, and allowing me to see this perception of life, and as hard as I go, keeping me healthy and safe and giving me this life to see from this perspective. Dear God, dear Jesus, thank you for healing me, thank you for healing my body, and dear God and Jesus, we love you. Amen. So, let's try this. I haven't It's raining outside. So noodles are a little undercooked, but that's okay. I definitely need some something. And I also have this broccolini. With our baby Bella mushrooms, that just tastes so divine. This is so good. I don't know, this is mid. This is mid skis. But this was pretty damn good. Man, what the fuck? Tell me what the fuck I'm on. I say it. Bitch, I'm on. I'm on some shit. I'm supposed to do. Am I supposed to like pretend that I have a family? pretend like I have a family. I don't know. I love talking to a camera, I'm not gonna lie. I have Gobi here.
Gobi!
Feel bad, I dropped Gobi on his head. But he keeps trying to escape the fucking little cage that I put him in while I cleaned his cage. He keeps climbing out. I keep having to grab him so he's not all up on the wires and shit. And then he's acting bad and I keep pushing him back in his fucking cage and, you know, you get what you get. Like, bro, like, if you want to come out the cage, you can crawl on my arm, not on the fucking tables. And then fall off the table, like. He can't even climb up the walls up in this bitch, like, it's way too slippery. So, also, one thing, I was like laying in my bed earlier and I'm just like kind of like scared, you know, because apparently New York just had a really bad earthquake and I'm not that scared because, like, I purchased earthquake insurance because I live in California. But what was I saying? What was I saying? I was talking about insurance. Oh, New York just had a earthquake, so I was just like laying in my bed, kind of scared because like, what if like the place that if there's an earthquake and this building collapses, it's gonna collapse, like, and I'm, it's not like a high rise, so that's that for one, but like, you know, just gotta pay attention, you know? And like, I don't know, I was hella thinking. I was like, so if there's an earthquake and say like I get caught, like if I'm like caught in like, then like the wood, and say I get impaled, right? I have Gobi, so if Gobi, if like he also goes down with me, right, and he's in his cage, right, and he doesn't get impaled, he'll climb out, and then if somebody sees Gobi, then they'll be like, oh shit, there's a person over there, you know. But that's just like worst case scenario, you know? Shouldn't even talk about that. It's like, but I should. Honestly, it should be talked about. Everything should be talked about. Like taking precautionary measures. Me and my fucking aunt. Like, that's really all.
be his protector.
I'll be up so late, just getting faded over.
But I'm so down to move to Texas. Like, if my man's down to move to Texas, we're moving to Texas. Like, straight up. Like, actually. Like, I'm there. I don't know. He gonna be there too. You know?
0422. It is 045 right now, so this is good for another 20 days. So,
with that being known, we're going to open this.
Fuck, I forgot to put his little...
Shit, dude. What the fuck? My bad, Gobi. Fuck.
Oops.
I still have to add... He likes to hide, so we're gonna... put some... vines on this side. Okay, we'll do one more. One more. Oh yeah. See that? Did you see how I did that with ease, you know? Should do one more. That's good.
about you. About you. All about you, you, you. All about you. All about you. Oh my God. Oh my God. We're gonna do one more. One fucking more. One more dollar.
Halafa dollar, Gubby. Halafa dollar.
That's great. That's fucking great. That's beautiful. That is beautiful. That is fucking beautiful. Yes, sir. Gobi, what do you think? Are you happy? Are you happy? Oh my. Oh my God. Whoa. This is so cool. This is so fucking awesome. I'll let him relish. All right. Well, hey. All my fucking plants are dead. But we got one in the middle. It's super nice. This one is also fire. This one needs to be repotted. These two needs to be repotted. And this one needs to be repotted. All of my plants are dying. In fact, I guess they're houseplants. And I have this one over here too. Also dying. So, yeah. That's my life. I just have a bunch of fucking clothes that I have to take pictures of and sew. And sell. So if anyone is interested in buying my clothes, let me know. And I will give you a good price. Even a discount, because why not? And yeah.